Hey guys, as some of you may know, I like to do a bit of an end of year summary, an end of year thing. Last year I did one, you've probably all been looking at it, my profile picture of some, not the profile picture, the background picture for my page. This year I thought I'd do something a little bit more personal, a little bit more fun. Quick video, see if you guys can read in lots of paragraphs, probably poorly written paragraphs. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy it and everything else. So, to quickly dive right in, I've donned on my best and favourite suit. Obviously a lot of you will know that I'm not lying about that. My race suit is generally my favourite suit. And as you can see, it's been a pretty good year. It's been ups and downs, but all in all, I can't be too dissatisfied. It's been a very, very, very good year. Very fruitful, to say the least. So I've got, I think, 28 trophies here. This isn't everything that I've accomplished this year. There's a few races that I've done, particularly the Carling Stone Championship, like the race at Rye House. Wilton Mill is the t-shirt you can see in front of me, and there's no championship trophy for that one either. I think there's one or two other races that I've done this year that there's been no trophies for. But I know I've won them here, so that's all that really matters. Yeah, so just to quickly go through a few of them. And on a side note, Wilton Mill, pretty clever with marketing, to think about it, you didn't get a free t-shirt. You're going to wear that, aren't you, or do things like this with it, but that's pretty clever. So a few key ones I'm going to run through, that mean a lot to me. So starting with this one here, Pay Summer Championship, one I've been after for, what is it? I think it was his fourth year this year. Finally had the ability and the luck to put everything together. First row win as well, so that meant a hell of a lot. I mean, I've tried really hard for really long to get that. And to finally have it all come to fruition, and in the way that it did as well. I mean, two out of three pole positions, two out of three race wins, and the race that I didn't win, I was, I think, off pole by thousands of a second and shy of the win by 11 seconds, which had to not change the pit stops for that race due to rules. The time that I'd lost in those pit stops would have been close, let's put it that way. It wouldn't have been 11 seconds, it would have been somewhere around half a second. I think technically with me in front, but that's not the point. The point is, I finally got the trophy. First EPS win for myself and for our team as well, Generation Gap. So that's a big achievement in the class. We were very, very happy with that, as you can imagine. And if you've seen my last trophy, we almost got a second one. Very close, we almost got a second win. The first cross the line, and then obviously, unfortunately, we had the issue with the weight. But alright, we'll come back strong on the next one. So, what else have we got? Q Office Championship, a new championship for this year. Met some lovely people throughout that championship. So, very, very competitive as well, which is what I love, because it pushes you to go faster and faster. What else have we got? Obviously a lot of Daytona stuff over in Milton Keynes, now that I'm spending a lot of my time up there, a lot of play stuff. You touch on a couple of the downs. It sounds weird it being a down, but it is. Third in the Winter Championship, obviously I was the current champion going in. If it wasn't for a couple of the liabilities being here and there, or something going wrong at least two of the races, I probably would have picked up the first for that. But to have a bad championship and still finish third is not bad going at all when you look at it in retrospect. But obviously we're all designed to win, otherwise we wouldn't do this. So yeah, so that was really good. Not the time, but looking back, I mean, to have that and still finish on podiums and still do well overall was a really good thing. The lemon. Very tired when this happened, and I'm not used to 7 minute stints and turn around that quickly. So went out without gloves on. Probably not the best thing to do, get a black flag for it. But I finally got myself a lemon, and it's very, it makes you realise, you know, even though you're still learning, you're still growing, you can still make mistakes, so it's very humbling to have that, I think, and also it's not the worst looking trophy, is it? Even though it's maybe not for the best reason. Ella Park trophy just behind it, that was a high, that trophy represents to me that I can go anywhere, any circuit, if it's brand new, never raced there before, and I can still be competitive. I finished second in that race, and only losing out to someone who lives just around the corner, and that is their home track, so says a lot to me. As racing drivers, we spend a lot of time at certain circuits, or only certain circuits. Obviously for me, I spend a lot of time at Clay, a lot of time at Milton, spend a lot of time at Bucknell. Over the last few years, but particularly probably playing with Milton team, you sort of have that thing in the back of your head, am I just a track specialist? Is it just because I know this track so well? To be able to go to Ella Park and to White House as well, I've never raced that before this year, and pick up a win, or the second place in this case, or the podium, it means a lot. Like, it fills you with confidence in your own ability to learn and to go out there and drive. So, yeah, that was really good. So going forward from that, we will segue into some new firsts, some personal growth bits and pieces for me. So this year has also thrown a lot of opportunities, and I have thoroughly enjoyed all of them, met so many great, fantastic people. Thanks to racing and to Club 73 and Clinton, and all the people that helped them out. I have funded on board as well, which was a first for me. Went and raced at 24 Hours of Le Mans, which, you know, is literally right by the Porsche curve. So as a racing fan, and just being able to say that I've raced at Le Mans is a huge, huge thing. It's not quite the car circuit just yet, and I am saying yes, so watch out. hopefully sometime in the future you'll see me on that. But yeah, that was a fantastic weekend, and absolutely unbelievable weekend. We even led the race at one point, our team. Thanks to Wally, who was in the seat at that point. And also, it was Clinton's team who took the lead from, so we had two of us touching the two guys up there, first and second for a while, which was fantastic to watch. The weather was wonderful. I was even out in the rain, which obviously, as you guys know, I love the rain, so that was absolutely brilliant. So I went from watching my first 24 hour in May over Daytona, doing my first 24 hour over Le Mans, thanks for coming through, and then doing my second 24 hour at Daytona with Team Camo. So thanks, Sam, for having me, and thanks to the rest of the team as well, that was fantastic. We did win, another trophy missing, but into team trophy from that. We did win that, Team Camo Girls, Common Girls. So that was great fun, and we were third in class at one point as well, and really good pace, so that was good. It was fantastic. I mean, this year's been all about pushing limits. I found a lot of time in myself, which is always nice, especially when you sort of know you're not slow anyway, and then you find that so much more. Just going throughout the year, and just kind of practicing time. And that's all most things are. The frequency from this year, it takes a lot out of you doing so many races back to back. And it's not just the driving at the circuit, it's too from, you know, having to think about all the food, having to think about everything else that goes into it. So it's been tiring, but it's been so rewarding. I can't stress enough just how much fun I've had this year. Longest stint has been extended as well. It's now 6 hours. Again, that one attempt that I did have at Bucknell, but it's the only outdoor track that I haven't taken a trophy away from this year. With the 1 6 hour that I did there on my own solo. Fantastic weekend. I did actually really, really thoroughly enjoy that, so that was brilliant. I got out and I know I could do more. Like I said, give me another 3 hours, give me another 6 hours, I'd go and I'd do it right now. So to know that I can drive that long, that consistently, finished fourth, which is a real shame. In my mind, I guess I should have been, but should have put a kind of serious shoot, but I'm a serious shooter at the end of the day. Can't fight that in the rain, unfortunately. But I can't be satisfied with fourth, like, as a soloist against teams of, you know, three, four, five people, however many there were. And they get some really, really quick people as well. Running second, first hour in a bit. But it is what it is. And I still thoroughly enjoy that. I know that I can do that. Pushing limits. I know now that I could, you know, the next goal would be a trial hour. If I was staying and passing it, the next goal would, you know, I'm just slowly passing. Just keep the weight down and everything else. Yeah, so obviously I've mentioned my drive speed as well. My qualifying speed, I found a way inside myself to just try and eke out that little bit extra when it comes to qualifying, especially at EPS. Down at Cape Higgins, I feel like my qualifying performances, especially towards the end of the season, have been really, really good. No outright poles yet, but very close to the last round, very, very close. I think 2 minutes ago I was in prison pole, with a dying track, so I didn't quite have had that perfect lap at the right time, unfortunately. 2 minutes too early. So yeah, obviously a lot quicker in cars as well now, I feel, and that's thanks to a lot of the practice that I've done, a lot of the more research that I've done, and thanks to the instructors at Winter Race. Doing that competition has really helped me progress, especially with my car driving, so thank you all very much. Let's go through, you know, a lot of the influential people this year. So thanks to all the teams that I've been involved in. Thanks to Club 73, thanks to Co-Part Engineering, Jeff and Pete who do that. I know Pete's got his kind of own stuff that he does as well. So thank you to all of you guys. Thanks to all the teams that I've been involved in this year, Team Camo. Obviously, thank you very much to my teammate Alan. It's always a pleasure to race with you, mate. So hi, Alan. In Generation Gap in EPS. So many teams this year in different events. So I want to say thank you to you all. It has been a pleasure. Even the team back in the 3 hour, I think I did right at the beginning of the year. Steve, you know which team I'm talking about. So thank you to all the teams and all my teammates as well. The teammates and extended teammates, you know, the other teams within our team, at Team Camo and at Club 73. Definitely go out and check out the Club 73 Championship. It's absolutely unbelievable. The talent in that championship is very fast, in the sense that you have some ridiculously good people all the way through to some those who are new people. So regardless of where you are at racing, you'll find people to race. Friendship element of that championship is the largest thing, so it's really, really great. Thank you very much, and definitely go and check it out if you're in that area. Go on Facebook, so go and find them. So circuits and marshals, people and staff that work at circuits, and everyone else involved in the championships that I've been involved in the 24-hour events and everything else. Thank you to all of you. I'll rattle up a couple of circuits and notes before they say play. The Eternal Teams, Buckmore, Rye House, Ella Park, Wilton Mill, Keyport, Constable, I want to know, we've kind of had a Nissan Championship. If I've missed any, I'm sorry. Obviously, Gorton Park and the stuff that we've got there. You've all been wonderful this year, so hospitable, it's been absolutely fantastic. Thank you all. Without the work that you do, we couldn't do the things that we love, so thank you. The Simply Race as well, something new for me this year, something I know that I definitely need to work on. It's not come as naturally as actually sitting in a car or a car, but it's definitely a very, very useful tool and becoming an outright sport in itself, so thank you to all the guys there. And obviously thank you to everyone who supports me. It does mean a lot to me when I see you guys live and comment and share all my stuff, so thank you very, very much. I am still looking for sponsors for next year, so I'd like to think that I've kind of proven this year that I can win I can be consistent, I can keep on the track, and I can win championships. So, even at the karting level, I don't race against people that aren't up there. You know, I try to always push myself down back to personal growth, and it's all about, you know, finding better drivers to race against. And in all of these championships that I've mentioned, some of the driving talent is ridiculously good. So yeah, if anyone is interested in sponsorship, please do contact me, send me a message, and we can discuss whether we're the right fit for each other, what I can do for you, and hopefully go forward from there. So there's lots of things obviously going forward that I have planned for next year. Something new to keep it close to my chest, and other things you already know. So if, I haven't confirmed it with you guys properly already, I know I've not done a specific post for it, but I will be racing for Formula B next year under AHS Motorsport, so thank you very much to you guys. The test day was fantastic, so watch out. I'm really, really looking forward to that. I've already been in the gym and started training, so yeah, after Christmas and after I've eaten a lot of turkey, I will be back for that. So don't think that I'll be getting big. I'm obviously still going to keep the chasing drivers a week if I can try. As Colin Chapman said, add power and you'll go faster on the straights, save weight and you'll go faster everywhere. So that is always springing rain into my mind. Along with if you're not winning, you're not trying hard enough. At some points this year, I'm clearly not trying hard enough. So yeah, but it all comes with time and practice, that's what it's all about. So yeah, everything else I will talk about in due course. One thing as well, I love Le Mans so much that literally before we even left, I'd already signed up to come back again this coming year. So it was a fantastic weekend. So if you get the opportunity to go out there, do it. It's amazing. So thanks again for all of your support, and thank you for listening if you bring it this far. I'd love to give you a nice little Easter egg at the end of the video to make it all worthwhile, but I don't really have fun. it generally does mean a lot, so thanks for all of your continued support and everything. Remember to keep backing the Boniface, and have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and all the best.